Hello and welcome to this Webflow tutorial. My name is Moritz and today I'm going to show you how to create this. The hero animation of the AirPods Pro website. So I'm going to break this down into 5 steps. Getting that animation from Apple's website, setting up our Webflow project, building the navigation and the layout, and finally building that animation. So let's dive in.
Alright guys, here we are. So, as I said, we're going to start by extracting the animation off from Apple's website. For this process, you actually need Adobe After Effects. If you don't have this, I've made an assets folder available in the description below, where you can download all the assets needed for this project. But anyways, if you have Adobe After Effects or just want to learn how I got this animation off from the Apple website, this next part is just for this. Okay, so to get the animation off from Apple's website, we're going to inspect the site, go to sources, and here are basically all the assets of the website. And in this upper folder, here are the assets for the animation. As you can see here, the animation basically consists of single images, and we have to download them all. For this, I have a plugin called Source Resaver. And you basically press this button here and it downloads the whole asset folder of the Apple website. I've did this already in advance, so I have a folder downloaded here with all the images for the hero animation, and we're gonna just drag this into After Effects. And now After Effects has this handy feature where you can just drag those into a new composition, and it's gonna create a new composition. And here you have to make sure here that there only are zeros and one at the end. So this ensures that every single image is one frame in the animation. We press OK, and now After Effects creates the composition. And as you can see, we have the animation and one image is one frame. All right, now to export this as a JSON file, we're using the Body Movement plugin. Here we have to ensure that we check enable compression and include in JSON. I'm also doing a little bit more compression to reduce the file size. We press save. We're gonna need to set a destination for this. I will call this hero animation, and we render this out to the desktop. Okay, so once the animation has finished rendering, you should have your JSON file on your desktop. And now we can start setting up the basic project. So we're going to open Webflow, create a new project, of course a blank site, and I'm calling this one AirPods Pro Tutorial, creating the project. And we can start by uploading our new JSON file. And after this has uploaded, you can already mouse hover over it and you can see the animation playing. Just like this. Here it is. So while we are at it, we can upload the other images from the assets folder as well. So just drag these in as well. There we go. And now we can start with some basic settings. So for the body, we want to change the font to System UI. For macOS, this will be actually Apple's San Francisco font. And another thing we're going to do for the body is set its background color to black. Next, we're going to create the nav. If you're just here to learn about that fancy animation, feel free to skip to the timestamp listed in the description below to go directly to the rebuild of the animation. Let's start creating the nav. So we first drag a section over, which we give the class nav, and we'll set its width to 100%, its position to relative with a high C index, just put 999 in there, and we give it a height of 44 pixels. So inside this section, we'll put a div block, which we give the class container. And this container class has a maximum width of 980 pixels, and we'll center this so it's neatly in the middle. And inside this container, we'll create another div block, which we give the class nav menu. And this nav menu has 12 pixels padding on the left and right. And it's set to flex, direction horizontal, align middle, and justify space between. All right, and inside this nav menu, we will put a text link, which we give the class navlink. And this one has a height of 44 pixels. And it's also set to flex in the middle and text align center. And we'll make the text color white. And this navlink, and we disable text underlining. We copy this 7 times. And we'll name this like on the Apple side, make iPad, iPhone, watch, TV, music, support. So, and now we will copy one of those 2 other times. And on the first one, we will give it the combo class logo, and we will remove the font or the text and give it padding of 10 pixels left and right. And now we will give it a background image, and this will be the Apple logo. And the width we set to 16 pixels and the height to 44 pixels. And center it and tile off. And for the other 2 we copied, and one's missing, we will drag those at the bottom. And so they are sitting at the end. And for those, we will remove the text as well. And give the first one a combo class of search. Also padding left and right 10 pixels. And we'll give it the background image of the search icon. And also width 16 pixels and height 44. And center and tile off. For the last one, we'll do the exact same thing. Remove the text. Give it a combo class, in this case it's back, and we'll give it a padding left right of 10 as well, and a background image which will be the back. This will 16 pixels and 44 height, and tile off again. All right, so that's the basic setup for the nav. One thing we have to do to get it right is we will go into a nav link without a combo class, set its status to hover, and now we will drop its opacity to 70%, and with the state non-selected, we will go into the transitions opacity, and that you can leave like it is. This will just make it smoother when you mouse hover over it, that it's not so abrupt. Yeah, so here you have it. That's our nav. So let's make this responsive. For tablet, it's we can leave it the way it is. Mobile landscape, it would work okay. So for mobile, we are going to set the display of the nav link to none. Or hidden, and the display of the Apple logo and the back to visible. Let's go back to the standard view, and we will add in the nav menu another div block, which we call mobile nav button. Let me check. This one has a width and height of 30 pixels and padding on the top and bottom of 7 pixels. So, and now inside this one, we will put 2 divs. First of all, one which we call mobile button line, and we will just copy this one another time. We will give it a width of 60% and a height of 1 pixel and a background color of white. And the mobile menu button has to be set to flexbox, vertical, and center and align space around. So, and now we'll just display this to none on the normal breakpoints, and on mobile we display this to flex. And there you have it. Next one is so Apple calls it the local nav. For this one, we will drag in another section. We will call it AirPods nav. Let me check. And this one we give a width of 100% and a height of 52 pixels. And we'll set this one to sticky and top to 0, so it stays, if you scroll down, it stays at the top. And also we give it a high C index, so it's always visible. And another thing to make sure of is that the color, it has a special background color, this one. And this one has an opacity of 70. All right, and inside this one, we'll drop another div, which we give our container class. And inside this one, we'll drop the AirPods nav content div. And this one, we'll set to flex, horizontal, and space between and center. And let me check. Yeah, and we give it a padding of 12 on each side as well. So, and now inside this one, we should give it a height of 25 pixels as well. Inside this one, we now will create a nav link, which we call AirPods nav title. It will be white color, not underlined, and let me check the font sizing, and 21 pixels font, and height 20 pixels, and we put the font white weight to semi-bold. All right, and the text says AirPods Pro. Now, inside this one, we will create another div block below the AirPods nav title, and we'll give this a class of AirPods nav menu. And this one will just be, this one will not have any attributes, and we'll put a link inside of it, which we give the class AirPods nav link. Again, color of white, and this one will have, oh no, it's not a white color, it's this hexacode. I think it's called white smoke if you add it as a global swatch. Yeah, white smoke, and not underlined. And this one has a font size of 12, and height we can leave this to 20 pixels. We will copy this one more time, and we'll make sure to add some margin on the left side, 24 should be 24 pixels. And the first one is saying overview, and the other one tech specs. No, typo, tech specs. All right, and then there's a button in this AirPods nav menu as well, and we will call this buy button. And this buy button, we first of all change the padding, that this one is 4 on top and 11 on each side, and we will give it as well a padding on the left, a margin on the left of 24 pixels. Background color, that's this one, and the text size is 12 as well. Text color, this one is white, completely white, and we'll give it a radius of 12 pixels, and the text should say just buy. All right, looking good. So responsiveness for this one, yep, should be fine. And for mobile, yeah, we have to change the sizing of this one. That's now 19 pixels. And the nav links, these will display to none. So that's just the buy button left here. Ah, yeah, and one thing we forgot is that this whole thing has a bottom border. We will set this on the AirPods nav section. Just give it a bottom border of one pick. It's not working. What happened? Let's try again. Now it's working. Buggy. And the color will be 2C2C2C. What's going on here? Interesting. Oh yeah, we've made a mistake. We gave this one also. Now it's working. So next part will be creating the basic layout of the site. We will start with the hero text and those text elements here. And to do this, we will create a new section, which we call hero. And this section we set to relative. Inside we will add a div block, which we call hero text container. This will have a maximum width of 980 pixels, margin set to auto, and its height will be 100 VH, and overflow is hidden. And it's set to flex, vertical, and both centered. Then another div block inside here, and this one is hero text. And that's basically the one which will hold the text, so we'll give it a padding at the bottom of 200 pixels, set its width to 100%. And now we will drag in an h1 heading, which we'll just give a class of hero headline. And this one will have a font size of 150 pixels, bold, and again the white smoke color, and its height is set to 0.667. And the text is centered, but we will set this on the hero text element. All right, let's change the text to AirPods Pro. So below this headline, we will add just a regular text block with white color. White color, top margin of 50 pixels, and a font size of 22 pixels with a line height of 1.17. And its weight is also 700. And this is saying, watch the film. Next, we'll put another div block into this hero section. And this one will be called hero scroll container. This will basically hold these little claims or bullet points coming up. This one will have a height of 500 VH and its position is relative. Another div inside here, and we will call this sticky container, and this one will have a maximum width of 980, will be centered, height 100 VH, and overflow set to hidden, and it's set to flex, vertical, and aligned both in the center. And inside the sticky container, we now create the bullet points. So we will put in a div block for the hero bullet points. And we will give this a width of 100%. And it's actually positioned absolute. Yeah, we've forgot to set the sticky container to relative. Now it works. Now I'll add a paragraph inside the hero bullet points. We'll just call this hero bullet text. And this one will have a font size of 64 pixels, line height of 1.06, and it's a white color, and also set to bold. Now let me quickly get the text off the Apple site. Active noise cancellation for immersive sound. Paste this in here. And it's actually center text. All right, and now we are just going to copy this hero bullets over and over again. Problem is now they are set to absolute. Let's set him to sticky, to static for now, so we can see what we are doing. So the next one is transparency made for hearing. This goes into here. Copy this another time. Next one, customizable fit for all day comfort. Next one, magic like you've never heard. It's actually four bullet points, not five, as I said earlier. Okay, let's set those back to absolute again, and we'll just make the opacity to zero so that we can animate them later and they're not bothering us here around. And now we will build the layout for the animation, and for this we will add another section, or let's add a div because it's not really a content section, it's just for layout. We will call this scroll sequence, written with a C. And this one is set to absolute and top to zero. And we will set its roof to 100%. And we'll give it a top margin as well. Okay. So, and just for now, we give this a height of 100 VH. And inside the scroll sequence div, we will put another div block. Who guessed? And this one is called sequence container. Yeah, sequence container. And it's set to absolute as well. Top set to zero. And its width and height are set to 100%. And inside this sequence container, we're putting another div block. And we're calling this image or animation sequence. And let me check if there's anything special. Yeah, this one will be set to sticky and zero to the top. And also to overflow hidden. Okay, so and now we'll put another div block inside of here, a lot of divs. And this one we'll call Lottie animation container. This will basically hold our Lottie animation. And this one we'll set to flex and center it. And we'll give it a height of 100 VH and a width of 100%. And it's set to relative. And now, if you have created enough like me, we'll just give it a padding, top padding of 52 pixels, so it's not conflicting with the nav. And now, all what's left to do is we'll drag in our Lottie animation into this container. We'll call this Lottie Hero Animation. And this one we'll give it a width of 100% and a maximum width of 1,458 pixels. And it's set to absolute. And make sure to set this one to canvas rendering, because for now with so large animations like this one, it kinda lags when you render it as a SVG. So load time is quicker with the SVG, but with canvas it's the performance is much better on scroll. Let's see the preview. As you can see, the animation is playing, but if we scroll, nothing really happens. You would expect this to stick, the AirPods. That's why, it's because we just gave it 100 VH height. You will actually need to give it the exact same height as the whole page. So we'll just can have a look inside here. This one is 100 VH, this one 500, so we'll give it 600. And now let's scroll to the bottom to check. Yeah, it's ending exactly there. Perfect. And as you can see, it's sticky instantly. Let's create the animation. We will do this by setting an interaction trigger onto the hero section. So let's go to the interaction panel. Add a while scrolling in view trigger. And we'll add a new scroll animation called hero animation. And what do we want it to do? Basically, we want to control the playback of the Lottie animation. So at 0%, we will select the Lottie integration. And we wanted to start at zero and at about, let me see, that's quite laggy because of the screen recording. 20%, I would say. We'll put it to 20, and when we preview, we should have made, this one we have to set to is fully visible, so that the animation trigger just starts when this one is completely visible, not this would be when it's already in the view, and that's when it's fully visible. All right, let's preview. Yeah, perfect. Maybe it's a little bit quicker. Let's make this maybe 17. Yeah. That's good. And let me check another thing. Yeah, we have to make an offset. 17. So on the end frame, we'll add an offset of 17%. And now the animation will end together with the end of the page. All right. The next is animating the hero bullet points. So we are grabbing the first one, and it should start maybe, let's start at 20. Just duplicate this real quick, and that set the first one to 0%. And we have to affect only the selected element, not all elements with this class. So I would say around, we have 4. So we basically have 80% left for this hero bullet points animation. So we are dividing by 4. Every element can have 20%. And they also move up and down, or the other way. They start at around 40 pixels to the bottom and minus 40 at the top. So that's basically the way they go. But if we preview this, I found a mistake. This sticky container, of course, should be set to sticky and to zero at the top now. Yeah, that should do the trick. Back to the animation. Let's have a preview of what we've built. Yeah. For this hero bullet point, we are just needing another opacity step at around 25%. So it's at 100% there. And then another one at 10% later, 35. And we'll put this to zero. So if we scroll now, you can see it's fading in and moving upwards, and then staying staying at full opacity, and then it's fading out again at the top. So, and basically this is what we need to have for every single of these items. So we're just going to select them all and hit duplicate, and we'll drag them over here, and now we'll have to sort this out. So that's the last one. This will be at 60%. This one as well, and that's the one that will be 5% earlier, and this one 10, and these two basically, before we move them there, let's change the interaction target actually. Just select them all, right click and click on change target, and we will select the second hero bullet point. And make sure you have it only affecting the selected element again. So let's move those two to 40% and let's have a look. Yeah, perfect. So now we will repeat this process for the other ones. We will duplicate, drag them over, and now we will make sure we set the correct frames. So 80% for this one as well. That's 75, 65, and then change the interaction target to the third one and effect selected element and those two to 60. All right, and one last more time, grab oil, duplicate, drag down to 81%. Let's change the interaction target to the last one. And we will have to sort this out to 100. This one as well. And that's 5 pixels earlier. This one, it goes to 85. And these two again to 80. And make sure it's only affecting the selected element. All right, we should be good to go with the bullet points. Let's have a look. Yep, perfect. And the last thing that's missing is actually the AirPods animation will scale down a little bit and fade at the end. So we're doing this one as well. We'll select the Lottie animation and we will scale this from the point where the bullet points start to fade in, 20%. Where is it? Scale from 1, put this to 20, duplicate to 100, and we will put this one to about 0.85. That should be good. Have a look. Yep. Nice. All right. And the final fade out of this, make sure this is selected. We will tap into the opacity, duplicate this one, and it's going to be to 0% at the end. Like this. Have a look. That's starting a little bit too early. Let's put this one frame further. Maybe another one. Yeah, that's good. All right. So basically, that's it. So the last thing to address is responsiveness. We will have a look here. Let me check which font size this will be. That's going to be 96. Let's change this to 96. And the rest stays the same for this. The text for the bullet points, this one goes down to 48 pixels. And this should be it for tablet. Let's have a look. Yep. Skills. Nice. All right. Phone landscape. We're not gonna address this one. And finally, mobile. The hero headline will be 62 pixels with a line height of 1.09. And watch the film goes down a little bit too, yeah, to 17 pixels. Okay. What we have to do is we will go to the LUT animation again and we will set its maximum width to 414 pixels. Yep. Okay. Then the hero bullet points. This one goes down to 41 pixels. Right, let's have a look. Nice. I think, yeah, one thing we have to do is the container responsiveness changes as well. For tablet, the sticky container has a width of 692 pixels. And for mobile, it's the width of 87.5%. Now it should be perfect. So this basically is it. That's the hero animation of the AirPods Pro website, completely built inside Webflow. We can publish this to have a look. Load time is a little bit slow, but still fine. Yeah, and it's working perfectly. Okay, that's the end for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to share any thoughts, any feedback or ideas in the comments below. And if you have any question regarding this build, feel free to reach out to me. All right, I will see you in the next one.